So what do you get when you cross the band Dragon Force, the movie Braveheart, and a guitar pick? Hey folks, Andy with you for another Nail Guitar Skills gear review. Today, we're going to answer that little quiz I had for you at the start by doing this very review. It is the Dragonheart pick, and that is the answer. Dragon Force, Braveheart, guitar pick, that's how my head works at least. It is the Dragonheart pick. Very cool little design is the first thing you'll notice about it. The second thing you'll notice is it is crazy thick. If you've ever picked up a bass guitar pick, you'll notice this is probably as thick, maybe even thicker. Now, traditionally, guitarists don't like to use picks that are too heavy. Some people do, but this is an interesting exception to it. The other thing that you'll notice is the bevel around the outside, so it does thin towards the tip quite dramatically. The other thing that stood out to me very quickly was the texture of the pick. It actually looks like wood, but it's not wood, which is good because otherwise it would whittle away very quickly indeed. Now, I actually picked up my acoustic guitar here to try it out the very first time, and when I first strummed it, all I could hear was pick sound, a lot of pick sound, and that is due to the texture. Hear that? That's texture, it's not straight flat, and that kind of ties in with that whole sort of woodiness of it. I don't know how they've got this texture to it, but you know, it's a very wood-like sort of texture, but tough as guts, it has not worn away at all, so it's definitely not wood. And when I checked out the details on the picks, they profess to be able to help you to play faster. So I thought, all right, well, I'll give it a second chance. I'll try it on the electric, and that's where it shines the best, in my opinion. Feels really, really comfortable. Great for getting a greater sense of control, especially when you're alternate picking. And thickens up the tone. Now, I'm not going to do demos here because it's just not going to come across in YouTube too well. Especially, you know, with any piece of gear, it really is a case of getting there and feeling it as much as hearing it. So rather than doing those sorts of things and going, can you hear the difference, which you probably won't, you know, I'm really just passing on my thoughts here. As always, you know, you can grab one yourself. I'm going to give you a link down underneath and, you know, try it out for yourself. The Dragonheart pick definitely has a place, and I really like what it's good for. So just my little pre-warning, the downside is not too great for steel string. It has a scratchiness to it, but obviously once you're amplified with your electric guitar, you're not hearing that scratchiness as much, especially once you're distorted as well. There it is, it's the Dragonheart pick. I will give you a link down underneath if you want to grab one. If you want to learn about what my standard pick of choice is, I'll give you another link down underneath, and I'll give you a bit of a guide as far as my thoughts about picks go as well. So I'll give you a link down underneath for that as well. And if you want to check out more gear reviews, I have loads of gear reviews here on Nail Guitar Skills. So you can subscribe for all that sort of thing, or you can check out more reviews on the main page. I have a gear reviews section, a playlist, in fact, that you can check out over there. And if you've enjoyed this video and you found it helpful, hit that like button and I will catch you for more Nail Guitar Skills action real soon. My name's Andy. Have fun playing your axe. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate your likes and comments. Don't forget to subscribe for more. For heaps more free training, check out my other channels. If you're on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, be sure to follow me for updates.